Hello and welcome on NITV. This is a video I call it an exercise of animation. So let's go. The first thing you need to do is to create an avatar, a character, put it inside iClone 7, and we're gonna start an elevator animation. So let's go. The first thing we're gonna do is we are going to create an elevator case. So go to create, go to primitive shape and choose box. Here, now inside, this is the box. Now what we're gonna do, this is the ground of the elevator case, okay? So we're gonna push the R key to resize it, maybe something like this, okay? R key again and give it this shape. Yes, like this one. Now we're gonna push the W key. We're gonna keep control key push and move it and duplicate this one. So we're gonna make something like this size. Okay. Now we're gonna duplicate this one. So W key and control, keep pushing control key like this. Now go in, get inside the E key to rotate. And rotate with the green, like this one. Inside the modify attributes of the box, you get the rotation. So choose Y90, push enter, and we're gonna move it. This is the side of the elevator box. Now R key and resize it, like something like this. Okay, W key, control key push, and move. We got the other side. Okay, nice. Sorry. And that's it. Now we're gonna choose the ground. We're gonna push W, control key push, and move it. We're gonna push the E key to rotate it, like this. Okay. R key to resize it with the yellow one. And we're gonna move it to the right side, just right here, and something like this, and like this. Okay, seems nice. Now what we're gonna do, we're gonna take all, we're gonna select all, like this one. We're gonna deselect the ground with control key and clicking on it. Okay, we're gonna go inside edit, attach. We're gonna choose the ground, okay. And now if I take my ground, all moving, okay, perfect. Inside modify attribute, we're gonna call it not box but elevator. Nice. Enter key. Okay, we're gonna move it to the side, okay. And now we're gonna save the project and let's keep starting the animation of the character. So double click on the character and now open the timeline, and inside the timeline you get this is my character name Liray. You get collect clip, transform and motion. So what we're gonna do is simply zoom out, and we're gonna use something everybody's got iClone 7 have inside his inventory. Okay, so go inside template animation, go inside motion and mix move thermal. If you have a mal, take mix move mal. Go down. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna choose simply down. This is here work start. So we're gonna double click on it. And as you can see, it appears inside Lirae motion. It's right here. So we're going to push play. So she starts moving. Okay. Stop. The animation stop here. So what we're going to do at the end of the animation in the case up called transform, just right here in the up case and the last frame, we're going to double click on it to make a quick mark. Okay. I'm going to save my work. So take a look. The character is moving just right here. Now she's right here. So she's walking. I'm going to click on the next frame, next empty frame right here, and I'm going to choose walk animation. So where is it? Walk is right here. Let's move slowly right here. Double click. And we're going to push play. Okay, we're going to wait the end of the walk animation. This is the walk, the end is right here. So go back here. This is the transform case. Double click on the end right here to make a point. Now we're going to click on the second one, just right here, and we're going to choose walk end. So double click on it. Okay, push play. Sorry. And she stopped here. So this is the end of the walk end animation. Go inside transform case and double click on the last frame. Nice. I save my work. So this is the place where she is. This is the place where the elevator must be. Okay. So I save my work. So now I'm just gonna choose my elevator case. And the thing I'm going to do right now, I'm going to go inside Edit. I'm going to go inside just right before it. No, it's nice. Okay. I'm going to click on it. I'm going to go inside Edit. Click on Merge Subprop. And now the elevator is only one thing. Okay. So I'm going to move my elevator. And as you can see in the timeline, my elevator doesn't appear. Why? Because I don't choose it in the timeline. So if you want to see your elevator, you get this icon here, track menu list. So click on it and look for elevator. This is here, prop elevator. Click on it. Okay. And now the elevator motion is appear. So right here, in elevator motion, we are going to move it in the good place. So first press the W key and move the elevator case to the good place. So move it again, like this. Okay, move down, and okay, our shoes are just right here. Perfect. Okay, perfect. She's gonna keep this place maybe a little more like this, and that's it. Okay. And now inside elevator in transform case, I got a new point just right here. This is a new point position. So what I'm gonna do, it's the right click on it, copy. Now I'm gonna go and start my first frame at the start of the video. My elevator is right here. I don't want him here. So here inside elevator transform key at the first frame, I'm going to click on the transform case. I already got a point. Now I'm going to click on right. I'm going to push my right mouse button and I'm going to click on past. That's it. And now if I push play, my elevator doesn't move. And this is nice. This is normal. So she came inside the elevator and she stopped. Okay. If you want to come back to the current frame, just click here in current frame and you come here. Okay. So this is the last frame. And now I'm going to choose the next frame just right here. I'm sorry, I think I'm ill. So I save my work. And now we're gonna change the end position of our character to get something more natural, okay? So go back to the start of the video, click on this house right here to check the character. This is the start, okay? Here you can you get a motion and a small arrow. Click on the small arrow and you get gesture. Gesture is for the end, okay? So right here in the first position, we're gonna go inside animation. Right here, we're gonna go inside apply gesture and we're gonna choose both. Now go inside content, animation, template, go down right here and choose gesture. And we're gonna choose something, something simple, maybe relax and relax position. Maybe this one. Caress B, double click on it, and she's got her hand like this. Now I'm gonna push play. I'm gonna follow my character with my camera, and here, as you can see, she changed her hand position. So I'm gonna choose the small arrow here, previous key and next key. Go to the previous key, go to the next key, if she wants. Just right here. So this is just right here. This is the start of the walk animation. This is the start. So I'm gonna click on this one, and here I'm gonna go inside the start, and in gesture, in the first frame, I got a point. I got something. So I click on it, right click on it, copy. Now go to the next animation. Just right here. Go to the gesture case here, right click and paste. Okay, now go to the next frame, just right here. This is not this one. Click on the walk, yes, next frame. Sorry, transform case, next frame. Current, go to current frame to find. Okay, choose the house to zoom on the character. And here, as you can see, she's got a flat end, so I don't want it. Go to this is the start, so click on the first frame of the animation. This is the gesture case, right here. Right click on it and paste. Okay, now go to the next frame, right here, and we go back to the start. Okay, so it's nice. Go to the previews, this is the last one. And now we're gonna move to the end of the animation. So go here to current frame, to the timeline, and we got a frame just right here. Nice. And we're gonna keep this one. So double click on the transform key. Okay, nice. Save your works. Sorry. Click on the next frame just right here. And now she's gonna push the button panel. So for that, we're gonna choose the first thing we're gonna do. It's to hide the elevator case. So choose the elevator case, go inside modify attributes, go down, and inside render state, choose this one, fireframe. That's it. Now choose your character, like this. Not the armor, the character. Okay, good. And now we're gonna take this side view, like this one. And we're gonna go inside here, animation, edit motion layer, and we're gonna choose the right end, just right here. Zoom in, and we're gonna move it, W key, and we're gonna use the blue square to move it. So blue, let's go to this position, like this, okay. Turn the camera. Seems nice, okay. Now we're gonna choose the E key to rotate the end, like this one. Okay, and now we are going to go inside. We can close this one. We're gonna go inside animation, apply gesture. So I want only the right end, so I choose right hand. Okay, Now I go inside content, animation, template, gesture. I'm gonna choose sign, and I'm gonna choose this one, 1A, double click on it, and she push the button. Okay, and if I move, okay, like this, she's pushing it, but the move she made is not natural. Look, she's pushing it like this, so I don't want this. So first I'm gonna save it, okay, and just right here, I go to the last frame, just right here, I'm gonna choose the motion here, the last frame, I'm gonna right click on it and choose break. That's it. And now I'm gonna move it to the right, like this one. And here, I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna push play again. And as you can see, the move is not natural. I want something very smooth. So for that, the things I'm gonna do, I'm gonna double click right here. Okay, she's moving. Okay, nice. So I'm gonna take this part, I'm gonna make it to the right, maybe here, okay. And now I want a smooth transition. So how can I do this? I take my mouse to the start, just right here. And as you can see, my mouse is changing her shape right here. So I'm gonna drag it to the left and I got a transparent square. I go inside this, directly inside the last frame of the previous animation, just right here. Just get inside like this and release. And now if I push play, yes, this is a better smooth animation. And if I want something more, maybe more longer, no, I think it's pretty good. Okay, so I'm gonna choose the start of this animation, and here inside transform, I'm gonna double click on it. That's it. Okay, so if I got a point of the transform case here, and if I push here, next key is gonna go to the next key. If I push the previous and come back, and if I push again the previous and come back to the start of the previous animation. So next, next, okay. Save your works. I'm gonna put my light on, sorry. It's dark at home. And now, okay, so it is good, nice, okay. Now I want her to move her head to look the panel, okay? So I am at the start of this animation. I simply go inside Modify, select my character, edit motion layer. I move my camera and I just choose my head right here, press the E key and just move like this, okay? And I can close it. And now, let's play. Okay, it's nice. It works. Okay, now save my works. Sorry. And now we're gonna choose another animation. So we're gonna go inside the one frame after the end of this animation, just right here. Double click. Do not make a double click. But before, go inside content, animation, go inside motion, go inside the mix move thermal, and we're gonna go down, and we're gonna choose, where is it, we're gonna choose a stand, this one, stand 03, and double click on it. And we got this stand animation. So, first thing we need to do right now, and where is it? It's to make the same as this one. So I take my stand free animation here and I move it here. And here we get the transition, okay? So the transition is simple. We're gonna move it to, this is the end. So one black, two black, three black. And we're gonna move it to the three black. And we're gonna extend the transition here. And we're gonna go, we are going to go just inside the first, the last one, here, like this. So here, this is the start of the animation. So we are going to make a double click on the transform case, right here. Now go to the previous key, okay, and play. And she's waiting. Perfect. Okay. So, I come back to the start of the video. No problem. So let's play. Okay. She's walking. Okay. She's get inside. She look and she push the button and she wait. Okay. So now let's go to this one. Where is it? Okay, so now let's save your works, and we need to go to the start of the stand free animation. So click on the first frame right here. Okay, the start, not the extend, but the start. And now we're gonna choose the elevator. We're gonna go inside transform right here, transform, and just right here. This is the moment, this is the first frame of the animation where she's pushing the key, okay? So she's pushing the key. So I double click on transform of the key of the elevator in the transform case, sorry, double click on it. Now this is the start of the stand animation. So I do the same. This is the elevator transform case. I click on the first frame, double click on it to make another point. Okay. And now what we are going to do is simply move the elevator case. Okay. So we're going to zoom out and we're going to move it up. So maybe again, let's move again, maybe here. Okay. Nice. And now what we're gonna do, we are going to go inside the end of the stand free animation. So let's to the end, okay. Go to the elevator transform case, and the end is right here. So this case is right here. So double click on it. Okay. Now go back to the previous key. Okay. Current frame to go in the timeline, okay, and now we are going to take this point of the transform key, this one, where the case is at the good place, just right here, okay, the elevator case. We're going to right click on it, copy, and here at the start of this stand free animation, just right here, we're going to choose this point of the transform key of elevator, and right click and past. Okay. And now, if I push play, the elevator case is going up. Okay, perfect. Go back to the previous key. Okay, current frame. And now what we're gonna do, it's simply choose the character right here. Up. Go to the next key. Oops, sorry, I come back to the start. Okay, so let's take the last key. Let's take choose the elevator. Sorry, go to the next key. Okay, click on current frame. So this is this one. Now click on select your character, and here inside transform right here. Just before, you're gonna zoom out and you're gonna move your character up right here to the good position inside the elevator. Okay, so zoom inside. I don't see the elevator, so click on the elevator, go to modify, attributes, go down and choose render state normal. Okay, select your character. Move it to the good position of the ground. So this is the good position, just right here. Okay, sorry. And now, inside transform case of character, double click on it to mark it. And now, go to the previous key, current frame, and this house to zoom on the character, and it's done. And now we're going to push play, and the character is following the elevator case. Nice. Wait, the end of the animation. And this is the end. The end is just right here. Okay. So now, what we are going to do, it's simply create, just save your work first. Sorry. We're gonna go inside, where is it? Okay, this is the start. So we're gonna go inside, we're gonna create primitive shape, and we're gonna choose floor. Okay, we got our floor just right here. So I go to the start of the timeline, to go back to the beginning. Okay, now my floor, I'm gonna change the size, sorry. I'm gonna move it like this. Okay, and now, okay, she's gonna stay here. And now I'm gonna choose my character. Just my characters. Okay, go to the next frame. The frame is the point you make by double clicking on the transform key. Okay, next. Next again. She's inside. Next again. And she's up. Okay. She's right here. So now I'm gonna choose my floor. Just right here. I'm gonna push my W. I'm gonna go inside the current frame. Right here. I'm gonna push my W key, and I'm gonna keep my control key push, and duplicate this one, and move it to the good position, just like this. I move it, this is the second floor, so I move it like this, and is it good? Let me see, okay, so we're gonna call this one, inside modify attribute, we're gonna call this one stage one. Okay, we're gonna call the first here stage ground. Yes, in English this is stage ground. It's hard to talk for me today. I don't know why, but sometimes it's more hard. So, okay, I think it's pretty nice. I'm gonna go to the start of the video. Okay, so we got just a simple problem, just right here. So, go back, move the video, tac. Okay, and this problem is right here. So I'm gonna choose my character again, go to the previous key. Okay, go to the next key, this is this one. Go to the current frame, and this is this one. And now, the elevator case, I don't need it anymore, so I just go inside the track menu list. I'm gonna uncheck elevator case, and now I'm gonna check stage one is right here. Okay, and now stage one is just right here, so click on the small arrow right here. This is the transform key. Okay, so this is the current frame right here in transform key. So double click on it, right click on it, copy, go to the start of the video, just right here, stage one, transform position, transform key, first frame, right click on it, and paste. Okay, and I think it's work. So let's play. The character is moving. Okay, she's moving. She's get inside the elevator case. She push the button. She take the elevator. Blah, 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 blah. She move. The elevator stop. And she stop. Okay. Stop. I choose my character. I choose the current frame right here. And I'm not here, so I go back a little. No, where is it? Ah, sorry, she's right here. No, Where is she? So next, this is the last and current frame. Yes, this is it. This is it. So I save my work. Now I'm gonna choose maybe one case, two, three, four, five case. So I click on the one, two, three, four, five case after, and I'm gonna go inside content, animation, template, mix move thermal, and this time she's simply gonna start work. So where is she? Look for start work. Start work. Double click on it. Okay. So I move it like this. This is the transition case. So get inside one frame inside like this one. Okay. Like this. This is the start of the work start animation. So double click on the transform case to make a point. And let's play. So she start moving. Oh, okay, perfect. This is the end of the start moving animation. Just right here. I'm gonna change. And I'm gonna take one frame, two, three, four, five frames. Okay, and I'm gonna choose. What can I choose? Maybe a dance. Simply for to finish the animation, street girl dance groove, maybe this one. Okay, so I'm gonna double click on it. Okay, this is the transition just right here. So I'm gonna make the transition just one case at the end of the previous one right here. I choose the start of animation here in the transform case and double click on it to make another point. And now what we're gonna do, it's simple. We're gonna move our camera. We're gonna keep our camera just right here. I'm gonna start the video at the start. I'm gonna push play and we're gonna wait. I'm gonna wait Lyre to come and to come out of the elevator. So let's play. Let's play. Let's play. We are waiting for her and she's coming. And I think we're gonna start see the elevator case. Yes, she's coming. She's wait and she's going out of the elevator. And now she's gonna start dancing. Nice. And this is the wait. I just see something I don't like. So I just click on my character. Previous key. Okay. Again, previous. This one. You see the end. Look the end. Go to current frame, just right here. And what we want, I want the start end position. So go back to the start. Okay. Go to gesture. Gesture just it's somewhere right here. So we go to the start. Push the current frame. Go to gesture. This is the first point. So click, right click on it, copy. Now choose the next key, 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 next key again. Oops, sorry, choose the motion, sorry. Next key, next key. Go inside transform. Again, next key, next key, next key, next key, next key, next key. She's right here, previous. The end are good. And this one, the end are not good, as you can see. So current frame, this is this one. Gesture, so go inside gesture case, first frame right here, right click and paste. Okay, and now push play. She's going out of the elevator case and she starts dancing. Yes, that's nice. And I think this is the end of the video. Okay, video stop. This is, I make the end here. So maybe go to the, this is the last frame of the dance. Okay, so I move my end and I put my little green flag for the end at the last frame, just right here. Okay, let's play again to the start. Let me move my cam. That's it. choose my character to get on her. And let's push play. Okay. So she's walking inside the elevator case. Okay, she pushed the button. Yes, the elevator starts moving with her inside. Sorry. And she's going out. And she starts dancing. And this is, yes, okay, perfect. That works. And I wait the end of the video. And that's it, okay. And I think this is good. Okay, so yes. So this video, I'm gonna save my work. So this video is finished, and I'm gonna close my timeline. Okay, and now it's up to you to do it by yourself. You got all the explication to make it yourself. This is a simple animation, but as you can see, you got a lot of things to make to have something nice on the screen. So I just say to you good luck and practice. See you in the next video. Bye bye.